Hello and welcome to my quick guide for the new upcoming hero Griffin. In this video I show you the most important things about Griffin. These are his moves, main pressure tools, hero specifics, hitbox, feats and perks. At the end of the video there's a little summary about what makes Griffin strong and where you want to play him. But enough talking, let's get started. Now to his moves. Griffin's moves are overall straightforward combined with a simple pressure tool. He has a versatile triple chain that he can freely mix with lights and heavies. So you can do a light, 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 or heavy, 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 or heavy, light, or heavy. It's up to you. Whatever you need. The downside of Griffin is he has no access to soft feints or unblockables to land big damage. So he has to rely on a 500 millisecond kick that he can perform out of a chains. So every time when you reach your finisher, you can perform Veteran's Kick that confirms a 28 damage heavy. And now you're probably thinking, wow, 28 damage for 500 millisecond bash, that's a lot. But here's the thing, if you manage to dodge it, the GB is confirmed. On a correct read, you can punish Veteran's Kick with a GB. That makes it a high risk, high reward move. But of course, you need a hero that can confirm a heavy out of a GB. The thing is, 500 millisecond bashes are really hard to react to, and people will try to dodge away, but all finisher lights are undodgeable, it doesn't matter in which direction. And all heavy finishers have hyper armor that allows you to trade in certain situations. Another approach would be to react to empty dodges and GB. Okay, now we learned that Veteran's Kick is his most important pressure tool. So he can also shortcut his chains with some other moves. A really important one would be the shove out of neutral. So it is 600 milliseconds fast and it confirms a light and you link directly into the finisher. Griffin has also a heavy dodge attack that links directly into the finisher. His dodge check is very useful, it deals 16 damage, it counts as a heavy, and the delay timing is very generous. That is a big plus. Another shortcut would be his lights. Every time when you land a neutral light, the second light in the same direction is guaranteed. It works basically like Shaman or Shinobi. So, if you land your first light, do a second one and you can chain directly into Veteran's Kick or of course into your finisher undodgeable light. Okay, now we have two more moves that links directly into his finisher. That would be his forward dodge light and his forward dodge heavy. So his forward dodge light is 500 milliseconds fast, and his forward dodge heavy that has really great tracking, but you cannot cancel it, so be careful with it. Last but not least, we have his zone attack. The zone attack is basically a JJ zone. It has a huge hitbox, is suitable as option select, and it does not consume 50% of the stamina. So that means you can do two zones in a row without getting out of stamina. And the zone is also considered as chain starter. That means it counts as the first attack of your chain. So after a zone, you can do another attack and get access to the Veteran's Kick. Or, of course, the undodgeable light if you want. Another here specific about Griffin is that every guard break throw will link into his chain finishers. So you can boss flat him and go for the top heavy finisher for max damage. If you go for the side heavy finisher, it only deals 2 less damage. In theory, you can also throw someone, go for the undodgeable light, or of course, veteran's kick, but it needs less damage. So it's just good to know that this hero specific exists. Another cool property of Griffin is Ironclad Tactician. Every time when you parry someone, your next light, heavy, or zone attack gains hyper armor. It's a real cool property to secure your damage in the teamfight. Like, the only thing that can interrupt your punish is a bash. Let's move to another big important topic, his hitbox. Griffin's hitbox is a big topic. I tried all the moves in general and almost all his attacks, including his zone and dodge attacks, have a very accurate and big hitbox, except for the second chain light. That's the only exception. In general, you can say that the hitbox matches the animation. This gives you a lot of options in teamfights or in anti-ganks. And as a little sweet bonus, all unlocked lights are enhanced. That's a big plus to avoid GB vulnerability if the unlocked light is getting blocked. Okay, now to the feats. His feats are very easy to explain. Like, his level 1 feat reduces the attack damage of your opponent by 25%. And his second feat is also very amazing, especially in teamfights. It has very short casting time and is super short recovery time. And if you... every time when you trigger it, you heal yourself and your teammates for 23 health. And now, in my opinion, to the most powerful projectile feat, and that would be his crossbow. Every time when you draw it, you deal 30 damage and you heal around 23 health. And it's almost unreactable. So, now to his ultimate. Basically, you throw a grenade with a very long fuse, deals around 50 damage, and the minimum damage is 32. But like I said, it has a very long fuse, and it creates a healing area. So it's basically a throwable stalwart banner. And it heals 50 damage. No, it heals 50 health. So that's basically all his feats explained in one clip. Okay, now to the perks. Overall, Griffin has access to 4 interesting perks, and these are Remedy, Feline Agility, Rapid Refresh, and Rising Dawn. The rest of the perks are not interesting or powerful at all. I would choose the following perks. Remedy gives you 10 health per hero kill. That is always nice. Feline Agility gives you 10 more movement speed for leveling up, and Rapid Refresh. Why Rapid Refresh? Well, he has 4 active feats with cooldowns, and you benefit every time when you assist, kill, or revive someone. And Rising Dawn is also a useful perk, but going for it means to swap it for Rapid Refresh, since it's a higher tier of perks. And it's actually not worth it. So, that is my recommendation for perks. And that's also it. I think we can move on to the summary of Griffin. Now to the summary. Griffin himself is a solid hero with a focus on teamfights. His hitbox and feats are extremely helpful for your team in larger teamfights. In 1v1, he's not the best duelist, but he's also not bad. You should never underestimate him. Players who are familiar with crowd control heroes like Kensei and JJ will have fun with Griffin because he also copies some of their best moves. That's basically it with my quick ride. I tried to summarize the essentials of Griffin and keep it short. I avoided topics like gank techniques and optimal punishes. This task will probably be taken over again by my YouTube colleague Freeze. So I hope you enjoyed that video and I wish you a lot of fun with the release of the season Mayhem. Bye bye.